Hey there, compliance officers and administrators. One of the most successful business tycoons of the 20th century, Aristotle Onassis, once said, "The only rule is there are no rules." Now, the ardent defiance of business leaders like Onassis or Ted Turner or John D. Rockefeller made them heroes. But I'm here to tell you that they would never have become legends in business without a good set of policies and systems inside their organizations to ensure those policies were respected. Running a business, succeeding as a nonprofit, or providing high-quality services as a government agency is a bit like playing the game of chess. Every organization is made up of many individuals, each with their own role, all working towards a common goal. Imagine, though, how chess would be played if there weren't rules and guidelines. Say the bishop. He gets annoyed because he doesn't have access to all the squares on the board. So he decides he should be able to move in a non-linear fashion and jump over other pieces. The knight can do it, so why can't he? It would be dreadful to be caught up in a game and have no idea of the rules. Rules ensure that the game is orderly, fair, and enjoyable for all the participants. Some people might argue, though, that rules stifle creativity, but it's not true. Do you know how many possible ways there are to play the first 10 moves within the rules of chess? 169 octillion. Business can be just as unruly. There was a software engineer named Susan Fowler that famously penned an essay about her time at car hailing company Uber, one of the most valuable startups in Silicon Valley. She described a drinking-fueled corporate retreat that included drug use, sexual assault, and an employee stealing a shuttle bus. The dysfunction and lack of proper protocols at Uber eventually culminated in the resignation of its founder and CEO. So there are reasons your organization should have a full complement of workplace policies. They set the standard of behavior and performance expected of employees. They provide a decision-making framework to ensure integrity and fairness when issues do arise. Plus, they help minimize legal and safety risks for your employees and your business. There are a few workplace policy best practices. First, communicate your policies effectively. A well-written policy will explain why it exists. It will specify when the rule applies. It will describe who it covers. You should assign policies to specific positions or locations depending on the type of work they do or the situations they're likely to encounter. For example, you might want to only assign a mileage reimbursement policy to salespeople since they're the only ones that drive in their personal vehicles to visit clients. A good policy will also show how the policy is enforced. It will also describe the consequences of a policy breach, and ideally, it will be written using simple language. At Workhub, we offer a number of policy templates, but you'll want to modify them to reflect your business and your culture. The next best practice for workplace policies is to ensure compliance. Prior to the advent of online systems like Workhub, organizations would publish policy manuals or employee handbooks. And the employers would often have a sheet at the back that workers would sign, and that piece of paper would get filed in a personnel folder. Now, to be frank, that acknowledgement method doesn't hold up well in the event of an incident, since the employer has no way to demonstrate that the worker spent time reading each policy, or that the worker accepted what was written in the policy. In Workhub, administrators can specify the amount of time employees must spend reading the policy before it can be acknowledged. Plus, workers have the option of leaving comments or even declining policies. And in that case, the system will notify the appropriate contact person for that policy. The third best practice is to keep workplace policies up to date. In Workhub, administrators can choose a frequency in which policies must be reviewed so that prior to them coming due, administrators can read the comments, look for regulatory changes, and then if they want, mark the policy as reviewed. And if you save that modified policy as a major version change, then workers would be required to read and acknowledge the policy again, which is important because you wouldn't want a disconnect between what workers were made aware of and the latest wording in the workplace policy. The policy component in Workhub has a lot of useful features, like adding a signing authority and linking it to related forms or competencies. So check out our help articles for steps and tips on how to make your job of managing policies a little bit easier. Queen to h7, checkmate, you win again. Honestly, this is getting discouraging.
Don't worry, Brian, you'll get the hang of it.